Owing to industrial action by the National Union of Journalists and the Broadcasting and Entertainment Trades Alliance, we can't bring you our regular programmes today.
With an estimated 18,000 BBC staff on strike today, many TV and radio programmes have been cancelled or seriously disrupted. In the South East, all the BBC's local radio stations were hit. Greater London Radio was typical. Not one of its presenters crossed the picket line, leaving just two managers to put out programmes and restricted news.
This will be a long-running campaign. It's not just 24 hours, and I'm sorry if it does inconvenience the public, but we have to draw the attention to the problems that we, the staff of the BBC, are facing, very serious financial problems.
The strike's over a 7% pay offer. The journalist and broadcasting unions are demanding 16%. They say recent pay rises have been well below the rate of inflation and claim the BBC pay far less than independent television and radio. According to the unions, a TV reporter at the BBC earning £20,000 a year would earn up to £28,000 with ITV. And a BBC radio engineer earning £11,000 a year with the BEEB would earn up to £14,000 with independent local radio.
We've tried debating with the BBC. It's the only way that we can let the public know that their broadcasting service is under attack. We're losing good workers all the time because they can't afford to work for the BBC anymore.
Pickets were out in force at BBC buildings all over the capital. Broadcasting House and Television Centre, where about 5,000 staff walked out, were hardest hit. News bulletins were shortened and other programmes like Breakfast Time were cancelled altogether. But some, like newscaster Nicholas Witchell, worked on.
I support and have great sympathy for my colleagues. I don't, though, support their methods today because I think it is wrong to take the news off the air, which is why I will be part of the process which ensures that there is a news service on the air at 6 o'clock tonight.
The BBC's base at Elstree was also at a standstill with favourites such as EastEnders and Grange Hill hit. The BBC's local news magazine, Newsroom South East, was also blacked out.
Firstly, the objective of today was to let the BBC know that their staff was very angry with them, and we have achieved that objective. Secondly, it's to try and persuade them to come back to the negotiating table. Now, we'll know later on this week whether we've achieved that objective or not. And if we haven't, regrettably, I'm afraid there will be further days like today.
Union leaders are claiming that more than half of the BBC's 25,000 employees have joined today's strike. The BBC have refused to comment on the dispute or the effect it's having on their programmes. But with no end to the dispute in sight, it seems more disruption and more strikes will follow. This is Mike Pearce at the BBC for Thames News.